Hi, fourth graders. Mrs. Maglio here with your lesson for today and drawing patterns on an egg. So I'm going to draw an egg and I'm going to divide it into 10 sections. And in each section, you're going to create a pattern that we talked about patterns that repeats itself over and over, whatever object, line, shapes you want to use. You can color it with whatever materials you have in your home. Okay, so I'm going to get started and I'm going to share some patterns with you first. Okay, let's make sure we have a paper and a pencil. I'm gonna do it in marker just so you can see it better. So first I'm gonna start by drawing an egg to fill the paper. Nice and big, I'm gonna start at the top and I'm going to come out a little bit because an egg is an oval shape, it's not a perfect circle, and it comes up and gets a little bit closer at the top. Okay, there's our egg. So now I'm going to split the egg in half with a straight line. You can use your ruler, you can do it by hand, freehand like me, a little wobbly of the box here. Okay, and I'm gonna divide it into four. 1, 2, 3, 4 lines. So we have 10 sections. And in each section, you're gonna use lines or shapes repeated over to make patterns. For example, I can use some zigzag lines repeated here. Here I can do some straight lines, go across and make an interesting pattern like this. Try to come up with your own ideas. Here's some diagonal lines, your own patterns. Try not to copy me. Remember how you decorate Easter eggs, they all have different patterns as well. So that's what we're doing here. Okay, some rectangle, circle, rectangle, repeating that shape over and over again. Some letters. And fill the space entirely the best you can. I'm going to use a swirl line here. I love the swirl lines. It reminds me of the stars in Van Gogh's Starry Night. Maybe some S's in here. You could do letters, you could do numbers, but really be more detailed and creative. I'm just trying to do it really quick to show you. Some curvy lines here, bouncing curvy lines. Maybe I'll do like a checkerboard here. And I'll finish it off with some circles. Okay, so you come up with your patterns and you could color it with whatever materials you like. Don't forget to send me a picture of your work. Good luck. Bye-bye.